Welcome students, welcome to this 13th lecture of non-traditional machining process. So this lecture we are going to see about the laser beam welding. Let us see what are the contents of this lecture. We are going to see about the laser beam welding, the advantages of laser beam welding, the disadvantages of laser beam welding and the applications of laser beam welding. So laser beam welding. So the setup of laser beam machining at the desired location in between the two metal pieces to be joined is done. So we have to set up the welding machine at the desired location. So this is the welding machine. So it has to be kept in the desired location in between the two metal pieces which has to be joined. After setup, a high voltage power is supplied to the laser machine. Okay, this is a connection which is given to the laser beam. One is given to the flash lamp and another one is given to the capacitor. Okay, so this, after connecting the high voltage power supply, this starts the flash lamps of the machine and it emits light photons. So last lecture we saw about how this flash lamp working principle of the flash lamp when we give the power supply. So with the help of this flash lamp, it emits light so that it induces the photons, it produces photons which incident on the ruby crystal rod. Okay, so the energy of the light photon is absorbed by the ruby crystal and electrons are excited to their higher energy level. So the photons from the flash lamp which is incident on the ruby crystal rod, so that the electrons in the ruby crystal are excited to their higher energy level. So when they return back to their when the electrons in the ruby crystal rod get absorbed photons from the flash lamp and it excited to the higher energy level, and the same electrons when they return back to the ground state, they themselves emit a photons of light. The same electrons when they come back to the ground level from the high level, they themselves also emit a photon of light. So this light photon again stimulates the excited electrons of the atom and produces two photons. Okay, the same photon which again stimulates the other electrons, so that also excited and that also moved to the higher energy level and again it's come back down, and the same time it also emit photons. Okay, so this process keeps continue and we get a concentrated laser beams. And the same process, it keeps on continuing. It's a chain process. It keeps on continuous, so that then we'll get a concentrated laser beam. So this concentrated laser beam is focused. So okay, it is focused to the desired location. So this is my desired location. So desired location for welding of the multiple pieces together. Okay. So this is the point where I need to concentrate the laser beam with the help of the lens. Okay. So that with the help of this high energy or high concentrated photon, I am going to focus towards the desired location of the metal pieces where two metal pieces going to get joined. So the lens is used to focus the laser to the area where welding is needed. Okay, so this, using this lens, we are going to focus the area where welding is needed. And CAM is computer aided machining and is used to control the motion of the laser. Okay, is used to control the motion of the laser and workpiece table during the welding process. This CAM is used to control the motion of the table, or this is the workpiece table or the motion of the laser. As the laser beam strikes the cavity between the two metal pieces to be joined, it melts the base metal from both the pieces and fuses them together. See, here is the welding process happening. When the laser beam strikes the cavity means the space between the two work pieces. So it melts the base metal. Okay, so that it melts the base metal. Metal initially in solid. So the using the laser light, high temperature is produced. That high temperature melts the base material, and then the both the material, both the melted molten material fuses them together. After solidification, we get a strong weld. So this is how a laser beam welding works. Okay, initially, once again I recall it, when the power supply is given to the flash lamp produces or emits photons. That photons is incident on the ruby laser rod. That inside that the electrons absorb the photon which excited to the higher energy level, so that and when simultaneously it comes back to the lower energy level, so that it emit photon of its own, and the same photon it's incident on the other electrons, and that electrons also get excited. So it is a chain process. So, it is a stimulated chain process. So when continuously this process is going on, so that it produces a beam of photons of light which comes out from the ruby crystal rod. In ruby crystal rod, one end is highly polished or highly 100% reflecting mirror, the other end is partially reflecting mirror. So from the partially reflecting mirror, the beam of laser light comes from the partially reflecting mirror, and it's incident on the lens. The lens focused towards the point where the machining or welding has to be happened. You can see here how the laser beam welding is happening between the two workpieces. Okay, let's see the applications of laser beam welding. So laser beam welding is a welding technique used to join metals and alloys through the use of laser. And it can be used to weld dissimilar materials which do not exhibit excessive hardenability. Okay, and this welding process, we can do it for the dissimilar metal. Dissimilar metal means the two metals are different. And different properties, but it is a different properties, so which do not exhibit excessive hardenability. Here the beam provides a concentrated heat source allowing for narrow deep wells and high welding rates. Okay, using this laser beam welding, this laser beam provides a concentrated heat source and allowing for narrow and deep wells and for high welding rates. And here the process is frequently is used in high volume applications such as in the automotive industry. Majority in the automotive industry, they are using this laser beam welding only. So laser beam welding is a versatile process capable of welding carbon steels, HSLA steels, stainless steel, aluminium and titanium. So these type of materials, laser beam welding is versatile or more frequently is appropriate for these type of materials. The speed of welding is proportional to the amount of power supplied, but also depend on the type and thickness of the workpiece. Okay, so here in laser beam welding process, the welding speed is directly proportional to the amount of power supplied, how much power is supplied to the machine, but it also depends on the type of the material and thickness of the workpiece. Now let's see the advantages of laser beam welding. So it produces high weld quality, and laser beam welding can be easily automated with robotic machinery for large volume production. Okay, easily automated with a robotic for large volume production. And now since we are using the laser beam as a tool, so here no electrode is required, and so no tool wears because it is a non-contact process. Here in laser beam welding, no electrode or no tool or metal is contact with the workpiece. the time taken for welding thick section is reduced, and it is capable of welding in those areas which are not easily accessible. So wherever the areas which are not easily accessible, in those areas we can use this type of welding, and it has the ability to weld metals with dissimilar physical properties. Okay, it has the ability to weld metals with dissimilar physical properties. You can have a different metals, we can use this laser beam welding process for joining, and it can weld through air and no vacuum is required. Some welding process they need a vacuum, but this laser beam welding we can normally use it through air, and X-ray shielding is not required as it does not produce any X-rays. So any harmful rays this laser beam is not produced, so no shielding is required, and it can be focused on small areas for welding. This is because of its narrow beam of high energy. Wherever we having a small areas, very pointed areas to welding, that place we can use this type of energy, and a wide variety of materials can be welded by using laser beam welding. And let's see that some of the disadvantages of laser beam welding. The initial cost is high. The equipment used in laser welding has a high cost. So everything is cost, initial cost and the maintenance cost is also high. And the due to rapid rate of cooling, cracks may be produced in some metals. Okay, so this laser beam produces a high temperature, and the drawback is suddenly the metals get cooled, so that this rapid rate of cooling may produce cracks on some metals, and high skilled labor is required to operate laser beam welding. So the welding thickness is limited to 19 mm. So up to 19 mm we can go for this laser beam welding, and the energy conversion efficiency in laser beam welding is very low. It is usually below 10%. Now let's see the summary of the lecture. So initially we see about the laser beam welding, then we saw about the advantages of laser beam welding, then we saw about the disadvantages of laser beam welding, and then we saw about the applications of laser beam welding. And this is the reference which I used for this lecture. Thank you, students. Thank you for this lecture. See you in the next lecture.